Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. And I'm a new student because I haven't been to the university to study the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament and get drunk with the old wine, desireth not the new. So, I'm a new skin. I have ears to hear. And I hear everyone and wet it in Holy Spirit, which is common sense. And then you get gospel through logical reasoning. If you are not capable of logical reasoning, you get nothing. Reincarnation is in the works of Yahweh. Resurrection is by the grace of our supernatural Father who give you Holy Spirit, the very Spirit that will make you to understand the gospel treasures. And that was given to the shepherd tending their sheep. To them the message was delivered, not to the temple high priest who were drunk with the old wine. They had no desire for the new wine. So if you don't desire, then you don't get. You must develop a desire before you can get it. So it's not something which is lying on a platter. You have to seek, ask, seek and knock. So here I'm rendering exposition of John 13 verse 21 to 38 with some gap. So, Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim Allah Parbrahm in different languages, delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in my native language Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God Elohim Allah Parbrahm that dwells in his temple. This is the temple of God, created by the demiurge potter, the lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah. They are demiurge, as Martian has differentiated. The greatest artist of all, is no imperfection in his art, and it is called Harmandir. Harmandir God, Mandir mean temple, temple of God, or Emmanuel. God is with us if you are not greedy. If you are asking for money, donations, then people who first formed the Church of God, they sold all their worldly possessions to join the first fold that was headed by Christ Jesus, our Bridegroom. And not like the old Church of England, Church of Scotland and all that nonsense. Church of England, that glorified soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, is a Church of Satan and nothing to do with God, loving and merciful. Emmanuel. So, no greed. Work hard. Be contented. To, according to St. John 13 verse 21 to 38. Reclining at table with his twice born. You remember, there are no disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. With the rabbi discipline, by teaching the moral of Moses. But our supernatural Father is free of the letters. And people don't need the disciplining here because they are men of Holy Spirit, common sense, and they know how to treat others and they know how to be wished, treated, treat others as you wish to be treated is the ideal. So there are many corruptions that the Messianic Jews have entered into the New Testament, and that bring in suffering to the people, fulfilling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, that the situation became worse than before the arrival of Jesus. That was the temple priest cars, their bishop, and that bishop in collusion with the Romans, they openly killed apostles, and they made a nice show of it to the public, how the apostles were eaten by lions and other things. So Pope is Antichrist, because everyone has to give his own account to God. Pope can't. So if a person cannot believe this simple fact, then he is good for nothing. He can't have gospel. So reclining at table with his Christ-born brethren, laborers, and not the once-born disciples of the rabbis, Jesus was deeply troubled and testified, "A man, amen, amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me." His twice born brethren looked at one another at a loss as to whom he meant. He had no loss, there was no loss, because they knew it, who the person was, stealing money from the church purse. So they were not at loss, but knew the thief Judas Iscariot stealing money from the purse. As today, these hireling dog-collar priests in the churches do so as their salaries and expenses, making the church to go bankrupt. That's why not many people go to the church, because you don't get anything real but sugar-coated sermon to get more money from your pocket. So, expenses making the church to go bankrupt. But they don't care. They want salary. That is why in Christ Jesus we have one fold, which is Mammon-free church. That is why the people sold all their possession to join that fold. So it is for Mammon-free church of God, headed by one shepherd, possessing the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, our Bridegroom Christ Jesus. And we have a fellowship of the royal priests, rendering exposition of the parables that the hireling priest cannot. Hireling priest cannot render the exposition of the parable. Now, I live near Oxford University, and I go to their seminar in Oxford, and I found them, they have no knowledge of the parables. They know they see the dead letters, and they read the Bible, because the interpretation will cause controversy, and those intake of the students is not mature enough to ask questions. They are just children, you know. So they can't understand the gospel without logical reasoning. But the teachers don't tell them that there is a logical reasoning. So I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. And one of the professors in Oxford University retorted that our duty is to teach the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament. The interpretation is up to the student. But you can read these things at home. You don't need to go to the university. So, the shepherd possessing the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, our Bridegroom Christ Jesus, and we have a fellowship of the royal priest, rendering exposition of the parables that the hireling priest cannot render. One of his brethren, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining at Jesus' side. So the once born but truthful Simon Peter, that was his nickname, was Peter, because he could not, nothing sank into his head. He could not understand the logical reasoning. So there are many Peters in the churches. So Simon Peter nodded to him to find out whom he meant. He leaned back against Jesus' chest and said to him, "Master, who it is?" Jesus answered, "It is the one to whom I hand the morsel." So the morsel after I have dipped it. That means Jesus had fed the people, you know, Judas Iscariot and others, with the same intention. But Judas Iscariot rejected the New Testament or the parables and he loving Mammon, money. So when you love money, then gospel has no place in the heart. It is always thinking of how to cheat people, how to deliver sugar-coated sermons. So that was the position. Morsel after I have dipped it. So he dipped the morsel and took it and handed it to Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, or the dominating, most clever Judah tribe, the princes of darkness. Whilst in India, we have the people of the Khatri tribe, kings and emperors of darkness. After he took the morsel, Satan was confirmed in him. Satan was confirmed in him that Jesus had pointed out. Jesus would fear none. I go to Oxford University. Over there I told the so-called priest in Christ Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. So where do you stand between man and God? So they have no answer. So I call them, anybody who stands between man and God, he is Antichrist and you are one of them. So when I point at the dog collar that you are one of them, they get upset, but they don't slap me. In India they would have done it. confirmed in him. So Jesus said to him, what you are going to do, what is in your mind, do quickly, now. None of those reclining at the table realized why he said this to him. Some thought that since Judah kept the money bag, Jesus had told him, buy buy what we need for the feast, or to give something to the poor. Remember, he was a greedy person. When Mary Magdalene broke the very expensive jar of perfume, then Judas Iscariot said, this could have been sold for 300 denarii. So he was a Mammon lover. Something to the poor. How could he give it to the poor when he was greedy? They knew that Judas Iscariot is hand in hand with the temple priest. So he was good friends of the temple priest. They were not stupid. So they knew it, he is the one. They were not stupid, or the other, they were wise people. That these Messianic Jews have corrupted the New Testament as well. They have corrupted the old, making full of holes, and say they corrupted the new. So he took the morsel and left at once. And it was night. This was the man who was thrown out of the wedding banquet of the Son, Christ Jesus. Remember when Father came, God came himself, he found one man not properly dead, and that was Judas Iscariot. He was thrown out into the darkness. There is no Mammon-loving thief among them. Wedding banquet of the Son, Christ Jesus, because Sadhus, Melchizedek, like Sadhus, they belong to the celestial world of souls. Sadhus do not handle money. If you become a Sadhu, you don't need to handle money. Any Sadhu who is begging, for money, he is not a Sadhu, he is a hypocrite. He put on that garb to make fool of the people. So in New Testament money, when Judas has left them, Jesus said, now is the Son of Man glorified. So Sadhus do not handle money, So when Judas Iscariot had left them, he went to the temple to bargain. Jesus said, now is the Son of Man glorified, because Satan is going to come to confront him. And they will kill a person for doing good at once. God is glorified in him. Man, let me read it again, New Testament as well, they corrupted the new as well. So He took the morsel and left at once. Judas Iscariot left at once, you know, because he was identified as the thief. And it was night. Remember when the father came at the wedding banquet, he found one man not dressed, then he was thrown out into the darkness. That is what made the night. There was the man who was thrown out of the wedding banquet of the son, Christ Jesus, because Sadhus do not handle money. When Judas had left them, let me know, they were purely devoted people, left them, Jesus said, now is the Son of Man glorified. So, Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. For loving people in agape, because there is no Mammon-loving thief among them. They are all devoted to God. That's why Peter killed Ananias and Sapphira, because they were having money kept back. They had one finger in money, one in God. No. They told lies. And that's lies. And bring chaos in West, you know. Mammon loving thief among them. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself. For God lives in his Mammon free temple, this one. And he will glorify him at once, my brethren, and not children, you know, as written in the Bible. Children have father, you know, then they will make him father. I will be with you only a little while longer. You will look for me. And I said, the Jews in the temple, where I go, you greedy priest cannot come. The proper priest in the churches, they are worse than those rabbis. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. So blind person, glorify at once, my brethren, not children, I will be with you only a little while longer. You will look for me. And as I told the Jews in the temple, where I go, you greedy priests cannot come. So now I say it to you. Simon Peter said to him, Master, where are you going? He was once born, he could not understand. Jesus answered, Jesus answered him, where I am going, you cannot join me, for you are once born and not once more, not follow as blind person do. People follow others blindly. We don't follow anyone. We have fellowship. Because what comes out of my mouth is, I am responsible. So same with other people. So when we are sitting together, we will act responsibly. Blind person do me now, though you will join me later. after going, sorry, after getting your reward of the Holy Spirit from our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Peter asked to him, Master, why can't I follow you? So it was Jesus and, sorry, Peter said to him, Master, why can't I follow you now? I will lay down my life for you. Jesus answered, Will you lay down your life for me? Amen, amen, I say to you, the cock will not crow before you deny me 3 times. Remember when he went to the temple, holding Christ Jesus, and over there, you know, Peter denied Jesus that he doesn't know, because the temple priest had arranged with the men to beat him very badly. So they were beating him very badly, blood coming around here and there. So that frightened the firstborn Peter. And Peter happily denied them. Because of the beating. So that is a sound proof that Jesus was beaten very heavily. Where the Roman set him free, Pilate set him free because there was no fault in him. So he did not beat Jesus at all, but put on the attire of a king, as they had tried to inspire him, you know, to beat or to kill Jesus, because there was another king going to fight against you. So their cleverness reverted back to them, and Jesus came. So Jesus became the martyr. So our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love.